Please rise.
It's a promise I'm making to you. Whatever may come, your heart I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you. I get to love you.
Good afternoon, everybody. We have come together today in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Carissa King and Trevor Bastien, to surround them with our prayers, to show our love, and to share in their joy. The scriptures teach us that the bond and covenant of marriage is a gift from God, a holy mystery in which two become one flesh, an image of the union of Christ and in the church. The union being established today is to be a lifelong commitment, ended only by death. Let us join our hearts in prayer for Carissa and Trevor. Lord our God, thank you so much for allowing us to come together today. The weather's worked out, and we are here to celebrate this next chapter in Trevor and Carissa's life together. It's an awesome experience that we get to be here together with fellowship and celebration. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Carissa and Trevor, we are here today to be joined in holy matrimony. This is to be a lifelong commitment that is considered in light of God's great love for us. The Bible tells us that God loved us so much that he gave his only begotten Son, and that if we place our trust in him, we can have eternal life. There is no end to the love God has given to us, and nothing can separate us from his love. It is this kind of love that we come to express through this marriage today. A love without end, a love without limits, and a love that is shared continuously without separation. This love can be achieved as you both live lives that are surrendered to God, his plan and his purpose, pulling him at the very center of your marriage in following his example of sacrificial love. As you enter this holy covenant of marriage today, we pray that you do so with all sincerity and reverence of God. God recorded his thoughts on marriage for us in the book of Genesis. It's not good for the man to be alone. I'll make him a helper, a companion. God put the man into a deep sleep. As he slept, he removed one of his ribs and replaced it with flesh. God then used the rib that he had taken from the man to make woman and presented her to the man. The man said, "Finally, bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh, name her woman, or she has made from man. Therefore, a man leaves his father and mother and embraces his wife. They become one flesh." As God created Eve for Adam, we believe today that he created you for each other. The scriptures are very clear. Here's that God's plan was one man, one woman, so devoted to each other that they became one flesh forever. With all humility and gentleness, bearing with one another I love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. God thinks so highly of marriage that he gives us guidelines for how it to work. In Ephesians 5, God tells the husband and wife how they are to carry out their marriage. Out of respect for God, he courteously reverent to one another. Wives, understand and support your husbands in ways that show your support for Christ. The husband provides leadership to his wife the way Christ does to his church, not by domineering, but by cherishing. So just as the church submits to Christ as he exercises such leadership, wives should likewise submit to their husbands. Husbands, go all out in your love for your wives, exactly as Christ did for the church. A love marked by giving, not getting. Christ's love makes the church whole. His words evoke her beauty. Everything he does and says is designed to bring the best out of her. Dressing her in dazzling white silk, radiant in holiness. And that is how husbands ought to love their wives. They're really doing themselves a favor since they're already one in marriage. Also, no one abuses his own body, does he? He feeds and pampers it. That's how Christ treats us, the church, since we are part of the body. And this is why a man leaves father and mother and cherishes his wife. No longer two, they become one flesh. This is a huge mystery, and I don't pretend to understand it all. What is clearest to me is the way Christ treats the church, and this provides a good picture of how each husband is to treat his wife, loving himself and loving her, and how each wife is to honor her husband. Now here we see God compares the marriage relationship to the relationship with Jesus Christ and the relationship Jesus Christ has with the church. He then explains the roles that each spouse is to fulfill. Still in Ephesians, first, as a husband and wife, you are to submit to one another out of a reverence for God. Trevor, to be the husband that God has created you to be, you must love Carissa as Christ loved the church. That is to lay down your life for her, to do all that you can do to help and enable her to become the wife that God has created her to be her spiritual leader, and learn how she needs to be loved, and to be the support that she can lean upon you as you live out God's purpose for your lives. Carissa, to be the wife that God has created you to be is to love your husband through respect and reverence. This means that you are willingly are going to follow his lead as he follows Christ, just as the church follows Christ. You look up to him as he sacrificially loves and leads you to fulfill God's purpose for your lives. He needs to know that he is your hero, the man that you have willingly given yourself to, just as he has given himself for you. Now, Trevor, this does not mean that Chris is going to be your servant or a silent partner that you can treat as inferior to you. Remember that God created woman from man's side to walk beside him and complete him as his helper. Marriage is to be a partnership, lived out side by side in love. Today, we have come together to celebrate your love for one another, a love that is defined in biblical terms. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. Trevor and Carissa, as individual followers of Christ, do you now, in the presence of God and your family, friends in this assembly, wish to join your lives together as one in the state of holy matrimony?
We do.
We do.
Trevor, do you wish to take Carissa as your wife and commit to being her husband?
I do.
Carissa, do you take Trevor as your husband and commit to being his wife?
I do.
Now, believing in God's will for you to become man and wife, we meet at this place today to carry on his will for your lives. You're already joining hands, so continue to do so. Smile at each other, face one another, and promise one another your endless love. Trevor, repeat after me. I, Trevor.
I, Trevor.
Take you, Carissa.
Take you, Carissa.
For my lawful wife.
For my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer and poorer.
For richer and poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
Carissa. Repeat after me. I, Carissa.
I, Carissa.
Take you, Trevor.
Take you, Trevor.
For my lawful husband.
For my lawful husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love and honor you for all the days of my life.
Now, do you have a symbol of your love to share with one another with rings?
Yes.
Okay.
Good enough?
Yep. Now, I'll ask again, do you have a symbol of your love to share with one another?
Yes, we do.
Okay. The wedding ring is a symbol of eternity. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in endless love. And now, as a token of your love and of your deep desire to be forever united in heart and soul, Trevor, you may place the ring on the finger of your bride. And I want you to repeat after me. Carissa.
Carissa.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
By the same token, Carissa, you may place the ring on the finger of your groom. And repeat after me. Trevor.
Trevor.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
These vessels of sand represent your individual lives, and empty vessels represent the life that you are now beginning together. Your marriage today represents the beginning of your new life, together as one. But you must remember that this is the beginning, and it's not simply just the beginning, and not just simply a clean slate. Both of you bring to this marriage many years of lived experiences that have made you the people that you are today, standing here today, and will continue to influence your lives. Yet our free will allows us to grow and reconceive who we are as a person throughout our lives. Please remember, as you're emptying your personal vessel of sand into the middle vessel, Consider how your life experiences have impacted your relationship with each other, and also how together, united through marriage, you will continue to redefine who you are and who you will become as you navigate life through together. Trevor, Carissa, as you're pouring your sand together in the center vessel, this symbolizes your two lives now becoming one. Just as the individual grains of sand mix together and become forever intertwined, so become your lives through your marriage today. As family and friends, we encourage you to give yourselves completely to one another. Center your lives and your love in Jesus Christ. And as you grow closer to him, you'll grow closer to each other. Pray with one another. Meet each other's needs. Solve your disagreements quickly and never look for a way out. But work together to prayfully be true to your commitment you have made this day. Strive together to find marital bliss. And forever remember the promises you have made today before God and all of your family and friends that are here today. For as much as Trevor and Carissa have consented together today in holy wedlock, making these solemn promises before God and with all of our family and friends here as witnesses, it is my distinct honor, with the authority vested in me by the state of Michigan, I pronounce you husband and wife. Not yet.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
I read you into it. I was like, it's okay.
Oh. Oh, I get to kiss her again. Oh.
That's the marriage bliss.
That's how it started. That's how I
did it. It is. It's okay.
Trevor, you may kiss your bride. Not yet. Not yet. Ladies and gentlemen, again, it's my distinct honor and privilege to announce for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Trevor Bastine.